And you were talking also during your speech about basically starting things early when you're young and not being afraid to tackle big problems.
Right.
And I'm wondering, does that mean that you could think about possible political run early, like maybe sort of
absolutely
after college?
Well, honestly, in my perspective, for me personally, after college, I would like to be a criminal prosecution attorney first. Then I'd like to become a judge. And then from there, go into public service.
You really do have it all planned,
don't you? I do. But for me, I want to learn as much as I can before trying to make decisions about these things. I want to have experience in criminal trials, in court. I want to have experience as a judge applying the law to everyday situations before I try to say that I know how it works and I know how things should be changed. I think that that'll give me the experience to understand how the laws are playing out in day-to-day life, and then from there be able to see what needs to be changed or what is working.
Now, you don't think Roger Ailes and Fox News is going to try to scoop you up first, right, and give you your own show?
I don't know.
See stuff like this and figure out you're half, that you're rather articulate.
We'll see. We'll see what comes up. You never know. What doors will open.
So it's not necessarily a set course then.
Well, again, that I always say that's my plan on paper, and you never know what will happen because God works in crazy ways sometimes, and I've seen that already. Miss America was never on that set course, and I had my life planned out till the day I die, and I had never even considered this being part of my journey, so you never know what comes up. You really don't.
Probably a welcomed curveball.
Yes, absolutely. No, I think it's a good skip year to have in between high school and college. I couldn't have asked for anything better.
That seems relatively reasonable. I mean, Miss America, I guess the one controversial thing that sticks out about pageantry in general is like the feminist aspect. People say that, like, the pageant objectifies women. What's your thought on that concept and also feminism in general in this country?
I think that any industry, any area of life, any job can potentially objectify women. It depends on if you allow it to or what your motivation is, that type of thing. I mean, modeling, dancers, gymnasts, whatever it may be, can deal with the same things. It's not just the Miss America organization that is making women a source of entertainment. You look on pretty much any TV show, any reality show, any competition, whatever it may be, many of them use it in the same way. And I don't think that is any argument for the organization, because that's not the purpose of what we do. That's not the goal. That's not anything that we're about or what we're based on. There's four fundamentals of the organization, and it's the reason there's four points on my crown. They stand for style, success, scholarship, and service. And that is the basis of the organization. And the whole purpose of competing in this program is to follow those four things and to encourage service in day-to-day life and continue scholarship and give women the tools and resources to follow their academic and career goals. And there is nothing that objectifies women about that. That is only empowering women to be able to have those tools and resources. I mean, for me, I can already see this is opening up doors and opportunities. This has now given me the money to pay for my whole undergrad, so now I have law school to focus on. The program gave away $45 million in scholarships last year. That is huge. That is giving scholarship assistance to women across the country who wouldn't be able to pursue their degree in any other way. And I think those are the things that people need to realize are beneficial and are positive that are going on in this country and that they can be a part of.
Well, does that stop you from getting attacks from feminists about this? Have you received any sort of criticism from whether it's you're talking about issues or you're talking about...
Honestly, not very much at all. So far, anyway. I know that there could be things to come in the future. A while back as Miss Nebraska, I had a woman who contacted me on Facebook who was very upset about this and was very critical of the idea of me fighting against eating disorders, but being a pageant contestant and being a Christian and being involved in the organization. And so truly I found that anytime I come across that type of criticism, it stems from these generalizations and stereotypes rather than truly understanding what it's about. So I explained to her that by having this title, I can now show others how it's possible to treat your body with love and respect and not turn to eating disorders to be successful. And through this title, I can spread the good news. I can use it as a missionary and evangelism tool, and that I can never compromise my beliefs or my morals and still continue to stand up for what I believe in. And afterwards, she did apologize and she did take back what she said, and people just need to understand that. But that doesn't mean that I'm advocating this for all, for anybody. If it is against your conscience, I would never encourage a woman to compete if it was against her conscience. But it's different for everybody. It's one of those things that in the Bible it talks about. It's different for people, and it is truly what you believe. And if you can stay true to your morals and stay true to your character and what you believe in and do this, then that is perfectly fine for you. And it may not be for another person. But the things that I'm focused on with my, especially my year and continuing from this, are continuing to tell others about my faith that has changed my life, to continue to tell others about that self-confidence and a healthy body image that you'll never hurt yourself to change, and to continue to tell others about finding something that you love and finding your passion and finding your talents and using that for the benefit of other people. Using that to encourage other people and build other people up and to give them the resources to then in turn do the same. And I hope to do that for other women, to tell them about this organization so that they know that this is a way that maybe they can do the same thing, that maybe they can pay for their school and reach their goals, that they'll have a new microphone and a new platform to address an issue that's important to them.
All right, one more real question before I get to the softball.
The softball.
Yeah, I hear you talk a lot about faith and values and character. Does that intersect anywhere with you with public policy?
Oh, absolutely. It's absolutely everything. And you see that no person, whether they claim to have a religion or not, can say that it doesn't intersect with their ideas and with public policy. It does. Inherently, your worldview will affect your worldview. I mean, what your religion and whatever you think about those things is going to affect the decisions and opinions that you have on any issue. And that is definitely going to be the case. But I think that will be a source of consistency as well. That if I'm ever running for a position in public service, that people will know that based on the Bible, they can see the decisions that I'm going to make, and that I will stay consistent to those things, and that I'll never suddenly throw a curveball that they were never expecting that I would make that decision, because they know where I stand on those things.
All right, now here's a softball question. Why should young people be involved in conferences like the one you're speaking at tonight?
Because learning something new is something that everybody should do, no matter how old you are. And conferences like the one tonight really truly is about learning about ideas and opinions from a wide span of people that you may not be able to hear from in your community or in your day-to-day life. And as high school students or as college students, we always need to be searching for those opportunities to find more opinions and to learn more and to take advice from others who have a lot more life experience than we do. And that's the only way we're going to be able to grow.
Makes sense to me. Miss Ameirca, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.